Hey, my name is Noni Rene. I'm a musician, singer, songwriter, and I'm here with Stokes Entertainment telling you all about the Village Movement. Pros would be I'm getting my education, I'm coming to school, and I mean connecting with other up and coming musicians. There are a lot of talented people on this campus. Cons, I would say, is that I don't get the time to focus on my art as much as I would like to. Along with getting your education, you have to actually do work, you know, homework and projects and such. And it's just unfortunate sometimes that I don't get to just sit and write songs and develop my ideas as much as I would like to. But I mean, besides that, it's a learning experience. Every day I learn something new, so I guess that doesn't hurt at the end of the day. I like that Stokes Entertainment is efficient. You know, I come to Stokes with my ideas, we lay it out, we record it, and then within the next couple days it's up on YouTube, and I like how quick it is. And I think, yeah, and also like it's just a real comfortable environment. We share ideas and come up with a good video, with good video concepts that we are able to put out. So, yep. Got the key, now you need to unlock the door to success. Downtown Girl, I wrote it so long ago, I gotta remember, but I think I wanted to create something that really embodied the city. So I'm from Philadelphia, but I live in New York, and so going to school in Brooklyn, summertime in Brooklyn is the best. There's like, it's just amazing. There's festivals every other day. There's like free concerts every day somewhere in the city. It's just a lot of culture and a lot of just celebrities just out eating and, you know, just artists everywhere in terms of fresh new clothing, great music, and just great minds, great thinkers who you run into. So yeah, just being in that environment, I really wanted to create like a song that kind of just embodied I guess my personal experience growing up in that type of environment where I'm dreaming big and I just want to become a star. You know, like I'm only a train stop away, well, several train stops away from Madison Square Garden, but I mean, you know, I hope one day to be able to like perform there. So I just wanted to like create something that really just embody that ambition, that feeling when you're young of just like, oh man, I want to be this when I grow up. I want to touch people. I want to be like, you know, so-and-so or whatever. And I think, you know, I'm very proud with the finished product. And my dream is to like get it in a movie one day. I feel like it's just like epic. And I can just imagine like a girl walking the street like, yeah. I'm very proud about it. That's a little story behind that. Nisha said he got him, so I wanna come and get him pinging on the beat, so I gotta get in this. Oh, no, he said something you never expect. But I thought, man, what the heck with me? You never know what's next. Well, I mean, when Mike released it, I just thought it was dope. And I mean, I just always thought it'd be a cool idea, like, to have a remix. I love the idea of remixes because I think I especially like features on remixes. I don't necessarily see a reason to do a remix unless you're bringing someone new into the picture. Or maybe if you just really switch up the beat in a crazy way. But I mean, I just thought it'd really be cool. I'm like, hey, you know, we're constantly, you know, talking to each other about music. And I mean,
we've done this and we know a couple of, you know, like not a couple, but like, you know, a bunch of other talented people. Like, why don't we just get together and like take something that's already like awesome and make it even more awesome by just adding some more really talented people on it. So, you know, and I just thought it'd be, not that I think that highly of myself necessarily, I'm confident, but I'm not like big headed, but you know, I just thought, hey, I'd really like to be a part of this. So yeah, that's just kind of how that came about. And we just sat, we all sat in the lab and, you know, got cooking. And that, you now you hear the finished product. And I think it's fun. I think it's awesome. And I enjoy it, so yeah. I'm sure that we've gotten to this point before. Alice in me was interesting because I could not think of what to write for the life of me. I was sitting here, I was listening to the beat, and I'm like, man, this is cool. You know, I want to do it justice. I don't want to just write anything to this. And I mean, I don't know. Maybe I was just putting too much pressure on myself, but I just knew I really wanted to just get it right, at least for myself, where it felt good for me to perform it. When I wrote it, it was around like October, and that's Domestic Violence Awareness Month. And there was just a lot going on around campus, and I heard some people speak on the topic and such. And so I really just think that it was just in my mind. I didn't consciously say, oh, let me write about this topic. But I think since like the environment was so much like, just that information was just everywhere. It was just very prevalent on campus. I think that it was just kind of like, it just naturally came out at the time. And then like, I don't know, I think I just might have been stressed, like, just period, because there was just a lot going on around that time, too, with homecoming and everything, and so I think it was natural to kind of lean towards, like, a darker topic, and even the beat is kind of, like, melancholy or, like, somber, at least to me it is, so, yeah, that's just kind of how it came about. I was just sitting here and just thinking to myself, and that's just what came out, and, yeah. People like it. But yeah, that's my truth that I shared on that one. Future projects. So, first and foremost, the album, It's About Me Now. Been working on it for almost a year now. So you can expect that. Unfortunately, I don't have a date. I'm not even gonna announce a date until I'm confident of when you can expect it. I'm a lot more confident when you can expect it. But just know it's in the works. There have been, with that, it's so funny because I started working on it and it was going well and then it just kinda stopped. And it's unfortunate, but I mean, hey, things happen, life happens. And you just learn from everything. So, you know, I'm working on that and I'm getting that together. So hopefully, I'm hoping maybe this summer, but I don't want to say anything yet. And then there's word that Nisha and I might be doing an EP, but I mean, not necessarily, you know, definite, but I mean, you know, just keep your eye out, soundcloud.com/TVKP. It's where you can stay updated with all of the songs that I've been releasing, and also facebook.com/thevillagekid, and I'm always posting on there, so you can definitely go there. Just stay tuned and stay updated on what's going on with the Village Movement. To all my supporters, thank you. Like, I feel like that's like a given. I don't know, but I can't say it enough. Thank you. For every like video view and listen to a song, and you know, if you share a picture or if you like whatever, I don't know, but just people who just keep checking in and keep following me, I really appreciate that, because I mean, I can't like make it if I don't have support, you know, like you can't go anywhere if people aren't like following you and asking for you to put out whatever or buying whatever. So I mean, just thank you. I'm very grateful. You know, I don't want to come off cheesy or anything, but that's all I can really say. I just appreciate everything. You know, maybe I pay attention a little too closely to the insights on Facebook that let you know, like, oh, well, so-and-so did this, but it makes my day to see people commenting and sharing things. Like, it's the greatest feeling, because then I feel like I'm doing something. I feel like I'm accomplishing what I set out to do. Like, I'm reaching people, and it just makes me feel very good. So just thank you once again. That's it.